Which is your vehicle of choice?
23 Carcass here. I've got something to admit.
Morning, Holly.
Here we are, a week army.
Morning, cattle over that side are coming over into this reed so they can all eat out the ad lib feeder. And we're only bedding one side.
There we go, job done.
Right, Kev's off there. I'm just going to head back to the yard as well. We are going to go and try and cut that seed today and see what it's like. See what kind of moisture it's bringing in. Going to put a ring feeder in here with some ammonia straw just because it's quite thin on the ground, the grass. So there's a couple of ring feeders just in there. Bonker here on some grass that's already chewed up. Now to just hope the rat doesn't fall on the bottom of the ring feeder. Come on, there he does it. Nailed it.
They're getting fired in about that straw anyway. No hanging about.
Just in time. The last dregs are there. I've had some helpers this morning. Before we get combining, I need to go and pick up a load of wood chip. So I'm heading over to the wood chip shop to get some wood chip. 23 Carcass here.
There we go. This is actually wet wood chip. It's for the sunflowers. Nothing to do with the wood chip boiler.
We put it down the ground in kind of crowded areas or where there's more traffic at the sunflower area just to make it a bit nicer. Obviously we don't need dry wood chip for that, and wet wood chip is cheaper.
Getting there, just about done. A couple more buckets and that's job done. Head back, dump this at the yard and then we'll go combining.
There we go, job done, full load. I'll hit the brakes a wee bit just to level it off. Right, we're off, we've got my line. 5.12 ton of wet wood chip we've got in there. And that's that, the new entrance is done. That's our current blockade for the moment. I'm just gonna sneak in here and then cope this wood chip in against this wall. We're just moving stuff and shifting stuff because we're gonna be cutting seed barley today and it can't get mixed with that, so it needs a separate pile. And there's bits of everything lying about. All the bits that are replaced in the grain dryer, a lot of that is scrap, so chuck it in a trailer and get a load of scrap made up. You ready for the clatter, bang, and wallop? Clatter, bang, wallop number two. Right, I'll pass that on to Dad. We're blowing it out because there's some of that barley lying about. And that is a different variety to what we're about to go and combine, which is a seed crop. Seed crops, we don't want contamination with any other crops because it's being resown. You just want the one type of crop in the batch. You don't want any contamination, so we'll blow it out. That gets rid of any crop in little cracks in the floor. This just needs a sweep out because it was wet wood chip. There's a wee bit stuck up the back. You can see it right up at the end there. Job done. I've got something to admit. This tractor, it's a sprayer tractor, which I use mostly. I've used this 90% of the hours it's done in the last 500 hours. I've just swept the floor of it. It was quite bad, but I didn't think it was this bad. I've got half a field in here, to be honest.
Builders are back this week, putting in the brickwork and the funds here. There's a mixer going.
Progression there, all going well. Right, let's go combine it. And hopefully not run over those flipping sheep. Bandits.
We're off to the races. I just saw that wee branch through the camera here and it looks like it's stuck to the trailer. I thought I'd nicked something come along the road, but it's just a tree.
So this is a new variety we're growing this year, KWS Tardis. So this is a seed crop, it is grown for seed stock. So this season coming, there's gonna be a lot of growers across the UK that sow what we combine today back into the ground to grow this, KWS Tardis. We will save quite a lot of this seed and all our winter barley next year will be Tardis. There's a couple of other decent two-row barleys at the moment. This one, which is KWS Tardis, there's Dazzle and there's Lightning.
They're the three varieties right now that are performing well on two row barleys. We're maybe a fraction premature in getting in here to combine it, but conditions are good. We're quite busy with quite a lot of other stuff along at home, so while we're at it, we'll just keep going, whack this out. There'll maybe be another 1% to dry out of it, but conditions are good. We'll get it cut while it's easy going. So green streaks, raw green streaks like this, were not an issue in the other crops because we sprayed them off.
That's the worst bit of the field, that's the first thing you see. There's a wee wet patch. Otherwise, this feels really good.
It may look like Dunk's gone AWOL, but that piece of ground just above where he's cutting, it was the bit that got sprayed out for sterile brome. There was quite a lot of it, and there was patches that got knapsacked and sprayed off. So we're not going to add that to the seed crop. We're basically going to leave that block till the very end. We'll cut everything else, put this seed crop into the shed, and then cut that bit at the end, and that can go back into the feed pile.
Right, we're loaded up with load number one.
First load, we're in. Now that I've figured out, I've set up this joystick how I want it. It's so good. Change direction with this, operate the back door and the bed with this. Drive up into the shed, boom, jump onto this joystick, change direction. Nudge it to left to lift the bed up. Once I'm backed into the pile, nudge it forward, that opens the back door. And then once I need to nudge forward, click that, and that changes my direction. Now I'm going forward again. Then float it to drop it, drop the back door, smash it. A wee bit tight coming out that door. Anyway, there's Daddy's chucking in the morning a straw bale into the coos. We're off. Another one done.
So it used to be kind of shop traffic in and out of this road and a way around to there, and this is farm and deliveries, but now this is all just farm and deliveries. New entrances all the way over that direction. This is blocked off, so we can now go out here with tractors, and the view either way is much better than going out that way.
Sun's belting down. This is either my third or my fourth load, I've forgotten. All going smoothly so far. Can't beat it. Can you spot where it was missed by the power washer? Dunk's finishing off this brake. Just going to unload him here so that he can open up a new brake and get all the way through. There we go, so the combine can now make it all the way through there without overflowing. So we'll get to the other side and then I'll pick him up going that way and top off my trailer. Combine's popped out the other side. Now I'll just nick in beside and fill up my trailer. There we go, filled up. Head back to the yard. Right, it's a few hours later. I'm charging through the field because I didn't make it back in time and Dunk has had to stop and he's waiting for me. Oh yeah! It's a smooth tractor, but it's not that smooth when you're caning it across tram lines. He's waiting up here. I had to stop at the yard and speak to someone about the container. Probably 60-65% through this field. Another 3 hours should get us finished. The ground is just like rock hard and it's all cracked. See all the cracks in the ground? It's dried out so much, just absolutely bone dry. There's nothing to it. Can't make much of a seed bed out of that. It is like absolutely solid. That's like a rock. It's kind of okay at the moment when we're combining, but if we want to try and make a seed bed out of that, no chance. There's just nothing there for a seed. Seed needs moisture to germinate and there's no moisture. So the seeds will just get sown and do absolutely nothing. The rain will come, it always does, but it is just very dry. We are typically, with the oilseed rape, we're looking to sow it not in July, early, but not in July, kind of very start of August. If we can get our rape in then, smashing in early, established early, try and get it up and away a wee bit before the kind of pressure comes from cabbage stem flea beetle. That's our general kind of method with the rape, get it in early, very start of August if we can. So we've got time for the rain to come, which it should come, touch wood, but when it comes it won't stop, no doubt. That's what happens. Someone else is shifting. I actually came along the road behind that combine and he let me pass, so whoever it was, cheers. Nothing worse than getting stuck behind farmers, eh? That is the last of the seed. This bit in here is just going to go into the feed pile. Smash. Dunk's just dropping the chopper because we're going to chop that bit of straw. Chopping this bit because it's going to be all different angles and short rounds, and just chop that block in there. Also, any brome that'll be in the straw will get blitzed as well, and we won't spread it to other yards via bales. Because there's more weeds through that patch as well, it's more raw, so straw would need longer to leave till it's able to be baled. So it's getting chopped. had quite a few people mention the fact that I've been in the tractor all the time, this new tractor, and I did say it's basically going to be Kev's most of the time. But Kev was on holiday last week when it arrived, and he just got back Monday, and we were straight away at silage first thing, then we were combining in the afternoon till late, and then yesterday and today both combining till late in the day. So I didn't think throwing the tractor to Kev without getting a chance to mess around with it and play with it and get used to it before he had to go and do some bales with it or cart a 31 ton train down the road, you know. So after this field's done, should have time to let Kev mess about, and I'll tell him the things that Mike from Reiki's told me last week, just to get used to it, because I wouldn't like to just be throwing it in tow 31 ton, get down the road. That is very different to the tractors we're used to, so it's hard enough concentrating when there's cars fleeing about in the roads, and then to add in a brand new tractor that you don't really know how to use properly. So that's why Kev's not in it yet. But unfortunately, I'll be relinquishing control to Kev. I'll nab it when I get the chance, because it is nice. That's another bonus to the tracks. You can cut in any direction because you don't feel the bumps going over the tram lines. As bumpy as anything for me though. Corker of an evening. I'll get one more empty and then Kev will get the rest, and that's this field wiped out and done. Finished, just as the sun's starting to disappear. Dunk's just coming up here. Where is he? Where's he gone? There he goes. Kev's just gonna get the last of it. That'll just be half a trailer full. I've got a full trailer full. Smashing. That's a good day. There's 57 acres in this field. We only started at lunchtime, so quite happy with that. It's about 9 o'clock just now. That trailer's still needing a clean. It was the one that was parked in the shed that the concrete got done outside of, so we couldn't get it out to wash it.
Which is your vehicle of choice? T7200, a 718, or a 6700 Lexium Combine?
Put it down below what option you're picking, or the Discovery Dad's just rocked up in. Shed has fairly filled up today. We've squeezed it all in though. We've not got anything else to cut for 2 weeks, so that's why we've not put any of this through the dryer yet. We'll get onto this just tomorrow. That's us, job done. Winter barley's all cut now. You can see it all sitting there. That is feed barley, that is seed barley. We'll start putting it through the dryer soon. The temperature's cooled down a bit now, so there'll be a decent temperature gradient to cool it compared to what there has been, so we'll get that dryer going soon. Cheers for watching. If you haven't already, subscribe, always helps. We're shooting for 8,000, and also click like. Cheers, see you tomorrow. I could hide neath the wings of the bluebird as she sings.